Well, I am a second year PhD student. I am working on the water and atmosphere above the Antarctic ice sheet. Today I am introducing you my current work, which is the third dimension of the structure of the snowfall over the Antarctic continent. This is important to remind that in Antarctica the major positive term of the surface accumulation is snowfall. Thus, we have to get a proper and precise understanding of the polar physical processes linked to the precipitation phenomena. However, there are limited observations in this region because of the extreme weather condition. Not only in Antarctica, we often analyze snowfall only at the surface level as the total accumulation of precipitation falling there. This is the second dimension vision of the snowfall field. We usually produce and 2D maps as the one on the left side of this slide. Here the new vision is that we can get one of this type of map at each level of the vertical atmospheric column. This way, at each grid point of the Antarctic continent, we get a snowfall rate profile to analyze in this work. As you can see on the right side of the slide, the 3D view of snowfall can be related to other meteorological variables that are often studied along the vertical axis. More complete dynamics and microphysics in altitude could be understood this way. This work focuses on the Dumont-d'Urville station, where we get a lot of observation and continuous measurements thanks to a well-established human attendance. It is possible because there is a less extreme climate on the east coast where DDU stands, just next to the ocean where lows are crossing regularly. At this station, we get microwave radar measurements since 2016 and also from the CPR of the satellite platform CloudSat, but only for the 4-year-long time series from 2007 to 2010. As you can read, the radars are complementing each other. The microwave radar is able to see lower levels and the CPR is more likely to get reliable information in the higher levels. MRR is originally made to measure rainfall, but it has been adapted and we use calibration constants in the current algorithm to be able to compute vertical snowfall rates. Data coming from the CPR of CloudSat have been treated by Lemoine et al. In 2019 to compute the first three-dimensional climatology over the whole Antarctic continent. In terms of modeling, we use the ERA5 reanalysis from the UCMWF. However, in its database, vertical profile of snowfall rates are not archived, so we have to compute it from temperature, specific humidity and snow water content. A recent study shows that the 4-year-long time series of ERA 5 that we choose does not impact much the annual average result. Here, I show annual snowfall rates profile, average over the continent between 2007 and 2010. There is a good agreement between observed and modeled snowfall quantities, especially in the higher levels. This result does not change significantly at various considered seasons. Next figure shows a local overview. Blue color indicates that the temporal averaging have been made over the CloudSat years 2007 to 2010. Red color indicates that it has been made over the MRR ones from 2016 to 2019. In dotted line, you can see ERA 5 profiles at the nearest grid point from DDU. Results of the MRR at DDU are shown with red crosses. The vertical profile with bigger dots is the one from the CPR measurement chosen at the nearest grid point from the station. Finally, solid lines indicate ERA 5 average over the whole low east region, and the ones with big dots are CloudSat means for this same area. DDU is characteristic from the east coast, that's why we investigate the result on this region as a whole. ERA 5 and CloudSat seems to overestimate snowfall rate quantities at the small spatial scale of the selected grid point, whereas at the larger regional scale it may be more reliable. even underestimating a little bit maybe due to the averaging of intense events. To conclude, those first results of the comparison between reanalysis and satellite-based observation to local in-situ measurements are encouraging. A more complete assessment has to be done on seasonal tendencies at DDU or at the East Coast region, but on the other region also. This way, we could evaluate the quality of both spatial and temporal representation of the precipitation processes and cycles in Antarctica in model or reanalysis, because there is little constraint coming from observational data and also from remote sensing instruments. However, we have to be cautious with the MRR data processing and the ERA5 SNOFAR rates profile computation as mentioned before. Thank you for your attention.